Meticulous Basketball. I am Mark Fikes Jr. Today we're going to show you a finishing series to help you with your drive to the basket and also your spin move. Work on your footwork and also work on your hand work in terms of getting the basketball away from the defenders so that you can finish without compensation. Let's get after it. So with the spin move drill, what you want to do is you want to have maybe two chairs or two garbage cans. Again, I like to use garbage cans because, first of all, we have access to a bunch of them around here at Concordia University, so I like to use them a lot. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dribble past the garbage can. Once I get in front, I'm going to work on a crossover to the outside and set up my spin move. Once I go to my spin move, I'm going to work on getting the basketball above my defender's hands. So if you have little guards that are down low swiping at the basketball, you want to do that spin move, get it up above the shoulder so that you can finish without confrontation, and also putting the basketball up here above the shoulder makes you play bigger than what you really are. After I score, I'll attack the opposite side, make my move. Let's see it. All right. So now we're going to work on your drive. What happens when you get past your defender and now you're going to the teeth of the defense? You want to work on protecting the basketball. Again, using the garbage can as a defender to help me measure how high I'm getting the basketball up. When I go around my defender, I want to pound the basketball and get it somewhere chest level. Maybe get it to my shoulder. Maybe I might want to get to my chest, or I might want to cover up like D-Rose. At the end of the day, I got to get it above my defender so now I can take my steps and get the basketball up without getting it stolen. You'll see me go inside, outside, the garbage cans to work on this finishing move. Let's take a look.
Go ahead.
The last one, the last series, now I'm going to go outside, in, working on my floater. Same footwork, same hard dribble, get the basketball up to the chest level, or shoulder level, then I want to work on my floater. Sometimes you don't have angles in which you can use the glass. Sometimes you got to use just touch, and you got to use it with your right hand and your left hand. If you watch these elite guards, Derrick Rose, Darren Williams, Chris Paul, they are very good at getting into the lane and using floaters or high arcing shots to get over the defenders so they can convert baskets in the paint. We're going to work on that same concept ourselves. Let's look at it. So there you have it. You go hard enough, you get winded. How would I do this drill part by myself? Maybe do 10 reps, maybe 10 makes, or if you have a stopwatch, you can go for 30 seconds, 40 seconds, or maybe even a minute, and go hard. Work on your left hand finish, your right hand finish. Also work on your footwork and different ways to attack the paint. You may go off with 1 foot, you may go off with 2 feet. But change it up a little bit so that when you get into game time situations, you're calibrated, you're ready, and you're prepared to make a play. These are all very good drills to help you work on, again, getting to the paint, hard dribble, getting the basketball up above the chest, maybe even above the shoulder, so that you can become bigger, you can become taller, and play bigger than what you are in the paint amongst the trees. More to come, Meticulous Basketball.